Hey everyone, my name is Patrick Mabilog. I'm back for another video on how to use Notion for your business. And today what we're going to talk about and what I'm going to show you is how to create a finance board for your business. Now, finance is obviously a very important part of business. You know, the way that your money comes in and out of your business, if we're taking better care of that, and if we can track that better, if we can manage that better, I think it can do a whole lot more for your company. And one thing that I have found as a freelancer, as a business owner, is that it's not always easy to track finances if you're not consistent. And that's why I love Notion, because with Notion, you have your finance tracker so readily available for you on your computer that it's easy for you to come in and just put in entries when you spend money, when you earn money, which is the best part of having a company of your own. But really, what I would want to show you today is how you can use Notion to really maximize and how to really streamline the way that you handle your money as a business owner. So let's jump straight into it. You can see right here, I have my Notion account ready. If you don't have a Notion account, all you have to do is just create one. The beauty of Notion is that there's a free plan, which more than suffices, I think, for the better part. If you do want to get a paid plan, then they do have very affordable plans as well. Now, the first thing that you want to do, of course, is create the page for your finance tracker. You might probably want to name that something along the lines of finance, right? Now, here's where it all begins. What you need to do when you're creating your business finance tracker for your company is you want to make sure that you have the right section. So what are the sections that you should have? Number one is you should have a cash flow section. What money's coming in, what money's coming out. Secondly is you need to have a budget section. Like how much do you usually spend and how much do you usually earn, so that you can get a good sense of your if your business is in the green, it's in the red, in I don't know what other colors there are, green or red. And lastly is you want to have an invoicing section. Now, the first thing that you want to do is you want to take these sections and you want to create them, turn them into pages. So to do that, all you have to just right click and then go into turn into and then select page. Now you can change the icons if you want. Cash flow would probably be a picture of, you know, like actual money or going in and out. Budget would probably have a clipboard. And then invoice would probably be like a receipt or something. So let's build out the individual sections. First, let's talk about cash flow. So cash flow basically is two things, right? It's money coming in, it's money going out. And so what that usually looks like in your finance tracker is you have two tables, right? So the first table would probably be, you know, the money coming in. So what you want to do is you just want to go /, and type in table, select the database table, not the basic one, because the database table will allow you to do more things. So when you do that, all you have to do is click on database. You can probably name it cash in. The beauty of the new update on Notion is you can actually hide the database title as well. But I personally like having it there. So what are the things that you need to have in your cash in table? So first is you have to have your entry, right? So the entry will probably, you know, you can just put in the name entry here. And then secondly is you'll have the tags. You want to categorize what kind of cash is coming in, so you can categorize it. I like to categorize it basically based on two things. Number one, I like to categorize it based on whether it's a fixed monthly thing that you get, or recurring amount that you get, or if it's just an ad hoc amount that you receive. So in my case, because I run a small creative agency, that's usually the scenario that I have. So I will probably have one for recurring income when people pay me a retainer and things like that. And secondly is you have ad hoc income, where someone pays you per project to create a website or something like that. So in order to do that, you can just go over to edit property. There's two different category settings that you have for this table column. And so usually you go for a select one or a multi-select. The difference between select and multi-select, select will only allow you to choose one category. So I think in this scenario, that's the best kind of database setting that you want to have. Rename that and probably put in type, right? You can put in your options. So in like in the case that we mentioned, you can put in recurring, or you can put in ad hoc or per project. So that's the second column that you want to have. Second column, next column that you want to have, of course, is where the money came from. And so you can either have this as a select type or a text type. Let's say, for example, you're a B2B business, right? And you know where your money is coming from. This is a good column to have because it helps you track which people are paying you. And it makes you see which clients are actually paying you the most money on a regular basis. So for this setting, for example, you can put in something like client name. And then you can put in the names there, right? You can put in a GFX company. And you can put as many as you want, actually. You can put in high income inc. And so on and so forth. You can actually put in the name of people as well, like Lynn Podetti. So you'll have your client name there, and so you can select and you can just keep on adding as you go. Second to the last would be, you know, the most important part, which is the number or the amount. So you can just have that there. It's pretty straightforward. And then lastly is you could probably have something along the lines of probably just comments that you might have for that billing in case you have, you know, additional comments that you want to add. And so when you're adding entries there, right, you can just put in like a retainer or so and so. Actually, there's another column that you want to have that I just remembered, of course, is you want to have the date received column. And there's actually a table entry type called date. And so it allows you to actually set a date. So you can actually move this around as well. So if you want to move this like further up there, that'd be great. That's your cash in, cash out, you know, feature, right? And then the next thing you do is you just put in the, you know, the content, website design, for example. And you can put in a date that you received the amount. Is this recurring? Probably a per project thing. This came from High Income Inc. Let's rename this to amount, right? And then you can put in the amount. I got paid $5,000 for this. You can also change the number to whatever sign that you have. So obviously, let's say I choose a dollar, for example. So there you go. And so yeah, you can just start putting in your entries. Second table that you need to have right there is your cash out, right? It's like how much money that you actually spend. So to do that, you create another table. And when you create that table, it's just a matter of putting in database entries again. So in this scenario, you still have entry. You can put a category for the expense. So edit property, select category. And categories would really depend on like what bracket does this you know, expenditure fall under? And you put the number or the amount. This is the one thing that's different with the cash in table is instead of putting in like the comments section or something like that, you actually want to put in, you know, a receipt upload, because like that's very important for a business. You want to be able to upload your receipts. So you can actually select here a file upload, files and media upload entry type. And so what that does is it allows you to upload a picture or a PDF of your receipt. And so when you have that, you can actually start putting the content. And last, of course, is to have the date, right? It's very important to, you know, get a sense of when your money is coming in, when your money is going out. So this one is cash out. And so you can actually start putting categories here as well, you know, like subscriptions, manpower costs, and so on and so forth, right? I mean, what else do you spend as a business? Rental, utilities, you get the gist. And there you have it. That's your cash flow table. Now, here's one thing that some people usually do. If you're the type of person that you like to fix them up according to, you know, months so that you have like a cleaner cash flow tables, what you can actually do is you can start to put these into like pages that will be labeled as the dates that you're putting in them in. So for example, you can have a page name here And you can say, for example, this is for March 2022. And you can put these tables into your that page right there so that it looks a bit cleaner, right? And so every single month that you're creating content, you're creating like a new table rather, you can just duplicate that. Now, how do you do that? What I usually do is I take that table and I will duplicate it and I will name it something. I would probably name it, you know, something like templates, template cash flow table. And the next thing I would do is I would head over to my options again, and there's an option here called template button, right? And what this does is it allows you to create a button that will propagate a template for you. And so in order to do that, you have two options here. Number one is the button name. So you can put something like new month here, because like what that's going to happen is when you click on this button, it will create a new month entry for you. And so I would move this template inside this section right here that says template. I'll delete the to-do that's already in there. And so when you close that up, every time you click on that, it will create a new month for you. And so every single time that you have a new month, basically to manage your cash coming in, coming out, you have that ready for you. So that's your cash flow table. Now, how about your budget table? I think it's pretty straightforward, right? So like when I create my budget table, once I have my cash flow table, it's just the cash out table, and you start to put in all of the expenses that happen on a monthly recurring basis. And so for you to do that, all you have to do is just copy this cash out table. So you can copy that and you select that, and you know, it's just Command C if you're an Apple user, Control C if you're a Windows user, and go over to budget and then just copy it there. Now the difference, of course, with the cash out table is that the cash out table might change with time, right? So you want to put in the content or the budget items here that really recurringly happen on a regular basis. So let's name this table budget for, I don't know, XYZ company. And then you want to start, you know, putting in the stuff that you spend for, like your Zoom account plan, right? So that would be under the subscriptions category. You can also remove the receipt column and the date column now, because like that won't be necessary for a budget. But you can just, you know, you put in the amount, right? It's $50, for instance. Once again, you can change that to a dollar figure if you want. And start putting in all the expenses that you have, right? Manpower costs, so VA salary. And VA number two salary, say, for instance. You can also put in, let's say, for instance, utilities, internet. Say, for instance, you have a physical office. You can also put in there rent for your business and start putting in the amount. Like, let's say you pay $1,000 for this. Now, here's where it gets interesting, right? What if you want to just see all of your expenses for a month that are manpower costs? You can do that by creating another view on your budget app. So what you want to do here is you just want to click on add view and select table. And when you do that, you'll have another table here. You can change the name. Say, for instance, you want to just change this name and you just want to see all the manpower costs. So you'll see there that it actually changes the name. And so what you want to do next is you want to filter your budget. So to do that, you can click on this and, you know, it will filter your entries based on, you know, what table you select. So let's say, for instance, you want to filter based on category and you want to just see all the manpower costs. So you'll see there that it shows you just all of just the manpower costs. And if you want to see the sum total, when you hover here to the bottom, you see the word calculate. When you click on that, you select sum, it will show you how much you're actually spending. That's the second part, right? Second to last part of your finance tracker. Last part, of course, is your invoice table, which you can probably even use to, you know, send invoices to people. So in order to do that, first thing you need to do is, of course, you have the table once again, right? And so you can create a new database table right there and put in invoice. when you're invoicing people, like what you usually put into your invoice, right? First, you probably have like an entry category right there. You can put in unit price if you want. And that will probably be a number entry. Second, you'll probably have a unit volume category, like how many pieces or how many graphics did I actually do for this person. And then lastly would be the total amount, subtotal. And once again, that will be a number category. Here's another like nice hack that I would like to share with everyone. I mean, if you want to have like an auto-calculating like invoice table, you can actually choose formula. And when you select that, you can actually create a formula where you multiply unit price with unit volume, right? By doing that, you just put in unit price and then the sign asterisk and then your unit volume, and it will calculate, you know, each entry, right? So let's say, for instance, you have an entry here that says, or let's say, for instance, we're talking about like an actual business with actual products, right? And you're billing someone on a B2B basis. So let's say, for instance, you're billing someone for a couple of units of a solar panel, right? Your solar panel business, and you're selling solar panels, right? So let's say each panel will cost $200. I don't know what the price for solar panels are. Obviously, this is just for illustration purposes. And this person buys 10 units. So you can see there that it actually changes into the amount, right, that you have right there. So you can also, once again, change the type of content that you have. You can put in as many, you know, items you want. You can also put in installation fee. You have, you know, unit price here of 500 per person, you know, per staff, and then two staff work on it. And then you have your total amount. And once again, then you have your invoice there. And just like the cash in, cash out, the cash flow portion, you can also create this into actual specific invoices per client. And so you can once again just create another page right here, an invoice number 000, right? And then you put this table inside that invoice. So you can change that icon, something a bit more, you know, visually striking. And you want to create like a template button once again, right? And the template button will allow you to create a new invoice. And then just drag that in there. And then close. And you have your invoice tracker. So every time you click on new invoice, it will allow you to create a new invoice for whichever client you have. And so I hope that was helpful. I hope that you learned something from that, and I hope that you'll be able to use this in your business so that you can continue to grow your business, you can scale your business, and you can take better care of your finances while doing so.